Hello and welcome to Railway World, your one-stop shop for the best, the worst and the funniest of rail-related videos from the internet. And in this programme we travel to Japan, Poland and Ecuador. And, like a headache that arrives after a really good night before, we shall inevitably have to take some pain relief for what is train crash of the week. Now then, here's an interesting fact. Over 49% of people who watch this show watch from the United States of America. God bless them. But that does mean, unfortunately, we have to adopt a more American style to the programme, and that means stopping for a commercial break before we've even really got started. What can you do? See you in a minute.
Travel the stunning Intercity 125 on business, and you're in an excitingly different world. One that's relaxed, business-like. A world you can work in. Even at speeds like this, you're not tied to your seat. On Intercity 125, you're in a world where you're looked after in real comfort while someone else drives. So you arrive fresh, feeling businesslike, all of which proves that for anyone going places in today's business world, this is the age of the train.
Welcome back. Now then, Rocket Boy 1950 is a train driver from Australia, and luckily for us, he's also a massive rail fan, and he takes his camera with him when he goes on holiday. Last year he went to Japan.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will soon make a brief stop at Kanagawa. Passengers changing to the Tsugaru line, please transfer at this station. Stop after Kanita is Kiko line. Thank you.
Very apt for this time of year. Many thanks to Rocket Boy 1950 in Australia for allowing us, the rest of the world, to see his footage. Now then, this show is getting more and more expensive to produce. For example, my wages alone have just broken through the £5 a week barrier. So to support it, we inevitably have to take some commercials, and we're going to stop now for one of those.
Kick off your shoes, rest your eyes, you'll catch up with me. A favorite book, a perfect company, relax. Forget about the moves, you're doing fine. Leave your cares and worries behind. Loosen up your tie, watch the world speed by.
Broadcasting to the world from the mighty Saffron Walden in the UK. Doesn't really work that one, does it? Anyway, now we head off to Ecuador, and this is courtesy of Valport in France.
Yeah.
lovely evocative film from Valpore in France. Merci, Valpore. And next we head to Poland for the waltzing experience, but hey, not before we've had a word from our sponsors.
Four are causing a 4 mile tailback. I'm going to get you out of the back of it.
The waltzing experience in Poland, where you can drive a steam train on the main line. Imagine that. Now then, must make mention of this t-shirt, which is for Found magazine. Nothing to do with me. This is a magazine for people who've, well, found things. And when they discovered I had the same surname as their esteemed publication, they very kindly sent me a goodie bag full of everything. Magazines, stickers, t-shirts. My little boy was delighted, and they're all over his bedroom window now, the stickers, that is. And you know, say what you like about the Americans, but in all my dealings with them, I've never found them to be anything less than really, really nice people. Apart from the immigration officer at Houston Airport once, who clearly had woken up in a very, very bad mood, and you know, I've never walked the same since. Timden Lake Railway is the creation of Chris McKenzie and his friends up there near Manchester, and it's brilliant. It's a live steam layout. I mean, a proper layout, you know, with modelling and all that sort of stuff. It's brilliant. Have a look at this. Thank you. Tibden Lake Railway there by Chris McKenzie and friends. Isn't that lovely? And that layout goes out and about all around the UK, and its next appearance is at the 16mm annual general meeting at Stoneleigh, where, by curious coincidence, I too shall be with the Railway Channel stand trying to flog some dodgy copies of Narrow Gauge in the Garden Volume 2. If you're able to get there, do please come and say hello. I'd love to see you. Now then, we arrive at Train Crash of the Week, and this is a black and white classic. I particularly like the way the engineer adopts a pose as the inevitable is about to happen. Me, I'd have jumped. There we go, that is it for this week. Hope you've enjoyed the programme, and if you spot any clips that you think the rest of the rail-loving community ought to see, then please do send them to me. mark@therailwaychannel.com is my email address. mark@therailwaychannel.com, there it is on the screen. And don't be too scared to send me compliments, because trust me, I can handle all that sort of stuff. Just before we go, final word from our sponsors.
Any minute now, you're going to see a cheap away day return make an ordinary day into an extra special one for my good friends here. Because the train brings people together. You hop on at one end, then speed away safely and smoothly with room to stretch out and move about. As it happens, the going's almost as good as the getting there, and it's so easy on your purse. Away day is an off-peak ticket, so it costs you less. Spend a day with someone you care for. It's much cheaper than you think, because of the train.
And that's it for Railway World. We'll see you on the next edition. Ciao.